The streets of Los Angeles turned into one big public toilet. Tonight, the NBC 4i team investigates a public health threat that is rampant across Los Angeles. There are 36,000 homeless people in LA, but most of them don't have bathrooms or access to the most basic human needs.
As the NBC 4i team's Joel Grover found out, the tons of human waste landing on city streets is creating an urgent health threat. First, a caution. Some of the video you're about to see is graphic.
A homeless man wakes up on South Hope Street. He unbuckles his belt, walks over to the front door of a business, pulls down his pants, and defecates right on the doormat in broad daylight, leaving behind a pile of human waste.
We are not in a third world country.
Maria Yanashi works in the building where the incident happened.
This is what happens in third world countries. We are in Los Angeles.
Unfortunately, people squatting between cars and urinating on streets is now a common sight across Los Angeles. Next to this West LA homeless encampment, this guy even urinated right on a cop car.
Public restrooms won't let us go to the bathroom because we're homeless.
Jennifer lives in this large encampment under the 101 freeway.
Where do all the people in these tents go to the bathroom?
In bottles on the side of the buildings, right here on the curb.
As far back as 2012, the county health department warned that piles of feces and urine on the streets posed an immediate threat to public health. Last year, a City of LA report said the shortage of public restrooms for the homeless was a leading cause of a hepatitis A outbreak in 2017. The problem of homelessness and public defecation is only getting worse, like in this residential neighborhood in Mar Vista.
My car has been defecated on not once, but twice.
Roman Samily and his family live half a block from the encampment.
I'm scared of the public health hazards.
Everyone's at risk at some level.
At risk because what's on our sidewalks could end up on your shoes, and you could track it into your home or office, according to Dr. Jeffrey Klausner of UCLA's School of Public Health.
People's shoes or their clothes can be contaminated. Then they inadvertently touch their shoes, they touch their eye, they touch their mouth. We can get viral gastroenteritis, norovirus.
A public health risk and a big cost to taxpayers to pick up all the bottles of urine and piles of feces on city streets. The City of LA now pays a private firm called Clean Harbors to clean up human waste and needles at a cost of almost $1.9 million last year. That's more than double the amount from the year before and six times the amount compared to the year before that.
The city should be putting porta potties out at every encampment.
But most of the city these hundreds of encampments are nowhere near a public toilet. In fact, LA has only 16 mobile toilet stations for its 36,000 homeless people. To make matters worse, with no funding for round-the-clock security, the city hauls away these toilets at night, leaving the homeless no choice but to go on the streets.
If you're allowing the homeless to set up tents, they should at least have a bathroom.
Why doesn't the city provide toilets to the majority of the homeless?
We simply don't have enough money.
LA Mayor Garcetti admits the lack of toilets is a crisis for his city.
We simultaneously have to clean up streets, clean up this crap, and build housing. And if I had enough money to do all three, we wouldn't be in this place.
The mayor tells me he might put money in his upcoming city budget for more toilets for the homeless. We'll be watching. In the meantime, public health experts suggest if you're walking in an area where people might be going to the bathroom on the streets or sidewalks, take off your shoes before you walk into your home or office so you don't track bacteria or viruses inside.
Pretty incredible, isn't it? NBC4 is committed to covering the homeless crisis with our Streets of Shame series. If you have a story idea, we'd like to hear about it. Just send an email to tips@nbcla.com.